Happy Sunday to all of us. Let us pray. Father, we thank you this Sunday. Thank you for your mercy, your faithfulness, your kindness, Lord, upon our lives. Lord, be thou glorified in Jesus' precious name. Lord, as we gather unto you, we ask, O God, by your Spirit, O God, grant us understanding of your word in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we pray for the nations of the world. We ask one more time, O God, Lord, that heal souls, O God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we declare an end to this pandemic, even all over the world, even in Nigeria, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father God, in heaven. Blessed be the holy name of God. In Jesus' and precious name. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're welcome to service one more time. And today we'll be continuing our teaching. I'll be looking at renewing our mind. Renewing our mind, which will be an extension of last week's service teaching. Amen, somebody. I will take this scripture again from Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Praise the Lord. But be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Amen, somebody. And from this scripture, the two operative words we are considering today is being conformed and being transformed. And we said last Sunday that to be conformed is to be pressed into a mold, to be influenced from outside, to be made to yield to external practices, often the carnal or certainly worldly system. So a new convert should not be conformed, should not continue and not allow the external influences and practices to determine his conduct in life. Amen, somebody. So Bible is saying that we should not be conformed, we should not allow the external pressure influences to shape our behavior. But we should be transformed. And to be transformed is to be radically changed from within and be able to influence your immediate environment. So to be transformed is a centrifugal effect from inside outside. Amen, somebody. And to be conformed is a centripetal from outside inward. So God is asking us to have an influence from within that will shape our behavior and influence our immediate environment. Amen, somebody. So, and the word transform is the same word as metamorphosis, like we learned last Sunday. It's the same word as metamorphosis. So we're going to look into that word metamorphosis as it relates to insects, you know, butterfly, especially, how they are changed, formed by the process of metamorphosis. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So we are using the same process, metamorphosis, in butterfly formation, to study the mind renewal expected of us by the Bible or by God, as it were. God wants us to be transformed. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
God wants us to be this. There are four stages in what is called complete metamorphosis. From egg to larva, which is otherwise called caterpillar, and to pupa, otherwise called the cocoon, and finally to the beautiful butterfly. Give us to draw similarities. Hallelujah. The egg stage is likened to our salvation, and it contains the complete genetic material of the butterfly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It contains the complete genetic material of the butterfly. So when we get converted, as it were, we are infused with the Spirit of God, and we carry the seed of God. The gene of Christ is in us. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And according to 1 John chapter 3, verse 9, 1 John chapter 3 and verse 9, the Bible says, whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. For his seed, the seed of God, is in him and he cannot sin because he's born of God. So if you are born of God, the seed of God, the gene of God is in you, and you cannot practice sin. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Essentially, your default setting is no longer carnality. It becomes holiness and righteousness. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So what motivates you, what comes naturally to you, is no longer carnality, sin. It becomes holiness. Amen, somebody. Titus chapter 3 and verse 5. Bible said, not by the work of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us by the washing of regeneration. So it's like our gene has been reprogrammed by God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
To live a righteous life. So our default setting is holiness. Amen.
Amen.
And renewing of the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this stage, all the egg needs is warmth. Like we said last Sunday, all that the egg needs is just warmth, a good environment. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
To grow and to become a lover. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So it all is conducive environment. It has no effort on the part of the egg, as it were. Amen. The egg can easily be destroyed at this stage, like we said. And so many Christians are, so many egg Christians, small baby Christians, can be lost at this stage, if not in the right environment. And so they cannot, may not be able to proceed to the next stage, as it were, of the mind renewal process. Don't forget that mind renewal is a process. It's not something that happens at 10 months, it's a process. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Just like metamorphosis is a process. From egg to larva to pupa to the butterfly is a process. And this process, this stage is vital. Amen. And people can spend few days, few months, few years at every stage, depending on application of self and help of the Holy Spirit. Amen, somebody. So a lot depends on your personal application and the help of the Spirit of God. Amen, somebody. So this stage, if not carefully observed, can lead to arrest of growth or loss of the human comfort. The larva or the caterpillar stage that we are looking at today, that is formed, is an active stage. So from the egg actually can become a larva or a caterpillar. But that stage is an active stage. The egg stage was a docile. A lot of influence from outside. We need to pray for the new convert. Amen, somebody. We need to pray for them. You know, like Galatians chapter 4, verse 19. Say, my little children, of whom I travail in birth again, until Christ be formed in you. So we are praying for the new convert, for Christ to be formed in them. So it's the elders, it's not Christians, the leaders in the church that are working on behalf of the young convert. Amen, somebody. To become, as it were, a caterpillar Christian, you know, a lover Christian. Amen, somebody. And at that stage, it's an active stage. What do I call it?
It's an active stage.
It's an active stage. All the caterpillar does is to consume, is to eat. They are very voracious. That's what they do. In fact, the leaf on which they are ash, they consume it. So they just eat and eat and eat and eat. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
They exhibit a voracious appetite. Okay? And this likened to the stage where a young convert gets aggressively into the word of God, reading and studying. Okay, if you have a Christian, a convert, that move from new convert as a class as to a baby Christian egg, and it's not, there's no zeal, there's no eagerness, there's no enthusiasm to read the word of God, his growth is arrested. His mind will not be properly renewed. He may continue to exhibit carnality as it were, because there is the process has been arrested. But if you have a Christian that's zealous for the word of God, is aggressive in the word of God, is reading and studying, he wants to read chapters after chapters, want to read all the available books. That's, and again, there's a thirst, there's an hunger for the word of God. That is the next stage. Okay? And those are the things that shape our mind. It's the word of God that we begin to read, begin to study, that will shape our mind. Amen, somebody. So he wants to know the mind of God concerning every issue. The things he has learned or he has heard, he wants to have a biblical understanding for them. What is the biblical basis for this, for that, for that? Even the doctrine of the church. What is the biblical basis for the doctrine of the church? Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
So, if finding biblical basis for life is lifestyle, why should I not do this? Why should I do that? You know, those are the things. He's looking at the word of God. Like a Berean Christian is studying to find out why and how. Amen, somebody. There's eagerness for him. So, he wants to unravel the mystery of the kingdom. Yes, and from that level of studying and reading the Bible, is willing to join the group, willing to serve. Amen, somebody. That's eager to be part of the church. Amen, somebody. And by the baptism of the Holy Ghost, he wants to serve in the Spirit of God. Amen, somebody. He has moved from discipleship class to service group. Getting enthusiastic with church activities, is part of the prayer group, is part of the evangelism, is part of the choir, is one of those groups. Protocol is there. He must find something to do in church. I get worried about people that are converted and for years they are not part of the activity. It looks as if they are arrested at the X stage. They just come to church, they want prayer for them, they can't do anything by themselves. They are arrested, they are not yet gone to the caterpillar stage. So they can still begin to misbehave. Hallelujah, somebody. They can still begin to misbehave because they are arrested. But you see a Christian that has gone from the egg, as it were, to an active stage. Being active in church, even somebody, and demonstrating a lot of power of God, things about Christ, that he has gone from the egg to the caterpillar or the lower stage. Even somebody, even somebody. And such people begin to demonstrate the gift of the Spirit of God. They see visions, they prophesy. Hallelujah, somebody. The knowledge of God through his word begin to modulate and modify his behavior. So you find out that himself knows what to do and what not to do, because it's been in the word of God, and the Spirit of God has been teaching him, convicting him, don't do this, don't do that. He begins to have a revelation, an encounter with the Spirit of God. He's no longer an egg stage where they do for him. He's beginning to do for himself. He's beginning to get active, even somebody. And that is at the stage where a lot of understanding comes from the word of God to modulate and modify your lifestyle. You know this is not permitted. Oh, God does not like this one. You know the will of God. You begin to understand as you read the Bible, that the Bible, you begin to understand the will of God. Amen, somebody. Like we read in the verse, say that we may not to do, that may be able to prove that good, acceptable, and perfect will. So as you read the word of God, you begin to say this is right, this is what God wants. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is the stage of the caterpillar. Amen, somebody. The knowledge of God through his word begin to modulate and modify his behavior and character by giving you a new set of thought patterns. Your thinking from your mind changes. Before, it used to be you are excited about frivolities, but it no longer excites you anymore. You know, like David said, now you are very happy coming to the house of the Lord. No, they don't have to make a phone call to you or come to your house to drag you to come to church. You get the light that are coming to church. But I was glad, I was happy when they said to us, let us go to the house of the Lord. And that is the state you get to. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Galatians chapter 4 and verse 6. Galatians chapter 4 and verse 6. And because he has sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your heart, crying, Abba, Father. Amen, somebody. You begin to behave in a pattern being modulated by the Spirit of God. Amen, somebody. As a son of God. When people see you, they truly know that there was a change in your life. But when you ask, what happened? You are converted. It chose. Hallelujah, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And now having freedom. Yourself having freedom and a conviction to say, God is my Father. I'm a child of God. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So you have a good and biblical understanding of why some things should not be done or why some things should be done. And you begin to make effort. You know, they say, let us pray for 30 minutes every day. You make effort. Say, let us go for a ballet. You make effort because you are eager. You are an active stage of Christianity. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
1 Timothy chapter 4. We saw the story of Timothy as a young convert going through these stages, as it were. Amen. 1 Timothy chapter 4, I will read verse 6 to 7. If thou put the brethren in remembrance of these things, thou shalt be a good minister of Christ. Nourish up in the word of faith. They are enriched by the word of faith. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And of good doctrine, and the doctrine of the church. I mean, every church has one way of the pattern of believe, as it were. They are nourished up in the word of faith. They are nourished up in the good doctrine of the church. Amen, somebody. We are all told that was attained. And they refused profane and old wise fables, and exercised themselves rather unto godliness. That's an exercise unto godliness. those fables, those old stories, all this, you know, you can be a Christian and fight. It does not tally. Okay? You can be a Christian and have three or four wives. It does not tally. All those ideas, you know, even help those wives themselves. It does not tally anymore. You begin to know what God says. Amen, somebody. And the Bible says, begin to refuse profane and old wives' fables, all those stories that don't have biblical basis, because they're now in the world. So all the things you hear, you begin to cross-check them in the Word of God. And those that are not tally, jettison them, throw them out. Amen, somebody. And begin to exercise yourself unto godliness. Amen, somebody. You begin to exercise yourself unto godliness. You want to get into activity. You want to do this. You want to do that. Amen. This is the stage where Timothy, like Timothy, you are admonished to be active and to serve. Amen, somebody. You need to serve. 1 Timothy chapter 4. I'll read verse 12 to 16. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12 to 16. Bible says, let no man despise thy youth. Be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. You see, these levels, you see changes in the caterpillar Christian. Amen, somebody. The way he talks, change. What it looks like, change. The conversation does not mean only verbal. Even your disposition, your behavior, your character, your courage, your dressings, you know, all those things have influence. You see changes. Amen, somebody. And you become an example. You say, as they see you, they call you pastor. As you speak, they call you pastor. You know, okay, pastor. You know, there's something, there's a change. Amen, somebody. In word, in conversation, in charity, in your love. You're no longer as aggressive, you are forgiving, you become gentle, you become meek. That's it. Amen, somebody. Mm-hmm. And in spirit, in faith, you don't begin to judge, you know, get afraid unnecessarily. Okay? You believe in God. Amen, somebody. Mm-hmm. And in purity, your lifestyle begin to demonstrate purity. Those things that you are used to, it's no longer there. Infidelity, stuff, you know what I mean? You begin to do away with them. Amen? Till I come, verse 13. Till I come, give attendance to reading. A caterpillar Christian is always, you see them with books, with the Bible. While they are not there, they are listening to tapes. No, they are doing things to enrich their spirit man. Amen? Give attendance to reading, to exhortation, and to doctrine. And because they are into the Word of God, and they are into prayer, into this, and they pray a lot, they begin to demonstrate and begin to manifest the gift of God. Hallelujah. They begin to see an expression of the power of God in their lives. Hallelujah, somebody. So, I'm about to say, do not neglect the gift that is in thee, which was given to thee by prophecy, with the laying of the prophets be. If they begin to meditate on these things, you give yourself only to them, that thy prophecy may appear to all. In fact, your people in your immediate neighborhood know that, truly speaking, you have had an encounter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you take verse 16. Say, take it unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them. For in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. You see, in your combat, he's ready to share his testimony. I mean, this is not a platform for personal testimony. A lot of things, as you get combat, you will be eager. Anybody that meets you, within the 5-10 minutes, you are telling them how God touched you, what else has changed your life. So you are eager to share your testimony. Amen, somebody. So at this point, you have a strong character formation. Amen. The time of every, and the time of these stages depend your, like I said, it depends on your personal application and the help of the Spirit of God. Amen, somebody. Some have arrested growth because they are not applying themselves. And some have accelerated growth because of self-application and help of the Spirit. Amen, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So, from the caterpillar stage, which is a very active stage, you can move to the cocoon, or we call it pupa stage. And at this stage, it's a less active stage. Amen, somebody. It does not mean that nothing is happening. Something is happening. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Something is happening. It's a less active stage, physically, but spiritually and internally, a lot is happening. Amen, somebody. At the proper stage, you don't see a change physically. It's not like the caterpillar moving from here to there, consuming this and consuming that. It's a bit, those are, it's a bit, you know, stationary as well. But internally, a lot is happening. So at this stage, we are talking of sanctification. We are talking of sacrifices. We are talking of fasting and prayer. Intense one. Amen, somebody. We are talking of personal retreats. Amen, somebody. We are talking of hearing God and being called of God. These are the stages we get to. And next week, by the grace of God, we'll be looking at all these stages. God will help us in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you.